Hey guys, what's going on? Hope you're all doing good out there today, and thanks for tuning back in. Just want you to know I never take it for granted that you guys are taking some time to tune into the videos. Just want you to know, much appreciated. And today I'm going to give you guys some good juice. I'm going to talk about the specific differences as far as where and how you can catch the three different species of bass: largemouth, spotted bass, and smallmouth in the lakes that have all three species. So we're going to get into that a little bit, but real quick before we get started, just a couple quick housekeeping tips. Just wanted to really remind you guys, if you all haven't had a chance to go by fishthemoment.com, check out our lake map breakdown sections. You know, myself, Matt Steffen, Johnny Schultz, we're putting out these lake map breakdowns of lakes all over the country, all four seasons of the year. It's a great resource to learn more about the lake you fish. Or if you've never been to a lake before, it's a great way to learn about that lake. And we also offer personal map breakdowns, so that's a good way to check that out. And also, just want to include, I'm going to include the Baitworks link in the description here. You guys know I'm working with Baitworks, and if you guys want to help support the channel more, a great way to do it is to go to the link that I'm providing with Baitworks. You can order your tackle there. They got everything you could possibly want, so might check that out. Much appreciated. Okay, let's talk a little bit about the three different species here. Now, what I'm talking about here, guys, is lakes that have all three of the species I mentioned. And a lot of lakes are like that. You know, some of the lakes, if you go down south, like in Florida, you're gonna have all largemouth. And if you go to some lakes like Sam Rayburn in Texas, you're gonna have largemouth and some spotted bass. If you go to a lake like Table Rock, you're gonna have a equal mix of largemouth, spotted, and smallmouth bass. If you go up too far north, you may have all smallmouth bass. But a lot of lakes across the country have some percentage of all three type of species in the lake. And that's specifically what I wanted to talk about here today. Some of the lakes have a more equal distribution. I mean, the Ozark lakes have a real equal distribution. Some of the lakes like in Kentucky and Tennessee have a pretty equal distribution. And overall, some lakes have, you know, just largemouth and spotted bass, so it's just a mix. But I'm going to show you guys, or tell you a little bit about the personality of each bass and where you sort of want to look for them in the lake if you have all three of them. So first of all, let's talk about largemouth bass. Largemouth bass in the impoundments where you have a mixed species, they tend to live shallower most all the year. They don't suspend as much as a smallmouth and largemouth, although they do suspend, but not as much as like a spotted bass or smallmouth. And they tend to live more in the creeks and the upper river extremities and the creek extremities, the back ends of the coves and shallow water targets. You take any lake across the country that has a mix of it, the farther you go up into a creek arm or the farther you go up into the main river arms, the higher percentage of largemouth that you're gonna find. Traditionally, a largemouth will seek out a little bit shallower and a little bit more stained water, and they tend to be more cover-oriented, object-oriented. And that's one of the big things that separates them more than anything else. So say, for example, if you're on a lake like we fish here at Table Rock Lake, and you wanna target largemouth specifically, if you run to those areas where you have a little bit more off-colored water, and the creek or river arms, it doesn't matter what time of year, you're gonna catch a higher percentage of largemouth than you will anything else. Now the spotted bass, in most lakes across the country, if you have a mix of spots in there, the spots are notorious for suspending. And based upon, or really depending upon the bank structure, but if you can take a lake like Lake Hartwell in South Carolina, Lake Lanier in Georgia, Lake Cherokee in Kentucky, Ozark Lakes, lakes out in California, Lake Oroville, that type of stuff. And spotted bass will tend to suspend more than any other species of fish in a variety of depths. So spotted bass will get extremely deep in suspend sometimes. They'll suspend in shallow water, but they also use shallower rock. You don't catch as many spotted bass around wood cover, with the exception of some docks. If you go to a lake like Lake Norman in North Carolina, you're going to catch a lot of spotted bass off the docks, or Lake Lanier in Georgia. But generally, they prefer rock if they're shallower, and they prefer to suspend a lot of the year. I mean, you take any clear water lake that has a big spotted bass population, and with the exception of the springtime of the year when those fish are moving shallow to spawn, a lot of times those Kentuckys are suspended all year long. They're the ones that get out there in open water and chase shad out in the middle of nowhere. You know, so from that standpoint, if you're wanting to target spotted bass, opposite from the largemouth, I suggest concentrating on the lower end of the lake a little bit more, just in the cleaner water, places where they have the ability to move vertically more than they would up the river. Largemouth bass like to move horizontally. Spotted bass tend to move vertically a little bit more. So that's how you target them. Now, smallmouth bass, again, a little bit different based upon the rock structure you have in the lake, whether it's gravel, whether it's bluff or rock. Smallmouth bass in most man-made reservoirs, unlike the lakes up north where they get on the big flats, smallmouth bass in man-made reservoirs tend to like deeper water, and they tend to like big rock, rocky bluffs, large rock, that type of stuff, rock transitions, any type of stuff like that. But you're going to find a lot of smallmouth bass on the more vertical, sharp banks, not necessarily offshore, but the sharp banks next to deep water. So one of the places that I look for smallmouth bass is I like to concentrate on the mid-lake portion to the lower lake portion on those lakes. And I really like to focus on any type of steep bank, channel swing points, bluff banks, all that type of stuff. If you have a lake that doesn't have, you know, a lot of bluffy type stuff on it, a lot of times those smallmouth will get out on the end of like the flatter gravel points, and they'll get out in really deep water. Sometimes those smallmouth will get like in 30, 40, 50 foot of water on the bottom. Sometimes they do suspend a little bit. Smallmouth will suspend a lot too, but they don't suspend in schools as much as the spotted bass do. Smallmouth bass, you're gonna find for the most part in a man-made lake, they tend to be in either real small wolf packs or loners, big rogue smallmouth. And spotted bass, they may school up in school of 50, 100 fish, but smallmouth tend to school in much smaller schools, and they tend to be more individualistic. And they roam a lot too. If you've got clear water on smallmouth and you've got a lot of flatter type banks, they roam around a lot on them. You can catch one in 10 foot of water, you might catch one in 40 foot of water. But they're a little bit more unique because some lakes simply have, it depends on the distribution of them. I mean, if you have a lake, for example, like Lake Cumberland in Kentucky that has a heavy population of smallmouth bass on the lower end of the lake, it's gonna fish different than a lake like, say for example, Stockton Lake here in Missouri that has the lake maybe has like a 15% population of smallmouth. So they're gonna set up and use different type of structures, but you can't really go wrong by fishing that shallow vertical rock. So anyway, just a quick overview, the differences, guys. Largemouth will live shallower all year long. They seek out dirtier water. They seek out shallow targets. They move horizontally. Spotted bass tend to like the mid to lower end of the lake, specifically the lower end. They tend to suspend more than any other species. If they get shallow, they tend to get shallow on rock. And smallmouth bass prefer lower end, mid lake, shallow vertical structure, steep rock banks, bluffs, that type of stuff. So I think if you just use that as the foundation, it sort of gives you a good starting point to what species you want to target. And some people like to target specific type of fish. Some guys that don't like to fish for spotted bass and smallmouth, the first thing they do is they're going to run up the river, up the creeks, and they're going to focus completely on smallmouth. A lot of you guys out there that are live scopers, you may want to roam out there in the middle of nowhere and chase those roaming schools of spotted bass. And you guys that like to fish smallmouth might want to put the little bitty hair jigs on and Ned rigs and go out there on bluff banks and points. So something for everybody there. So anyway, guys, hope that helped out. Again, thanks for tuning in. Please hit that subscribe button if you haven't, and we'll see y'all later.